If you want to become an exceptional hunter, then this is the ideal training ground. But from here on out, whether we win or lose, it's going to be hell. During these fights, I can't keep looking out for you. If you can't beat them, then you'd better go back, or else you'd just be a hindrance. Hello and welcome to Hunter x Hunter 101, the series that breaks down everyone and everything in the Hunter x Hunter world. And today, we are going to be delving into the stoic student of Jing Freaks and role model of Gone Freaks, Kite. Kite is a tall, gaunt-looking hunter who was introduced all the way back in Chapter 1 of the series. He generally appears very serious and cold-hearted, however underneath that, Kite has a genuinely warm nature and is particularly fond of animals. And with that in mind, Kite's primary action in Chapter 1 of the story was to save Gon from a fox bear mother who was attacking him in order to defend her cub. Kite, regrettably, killed the fox bear in order to save Gon, but then proceeded to chastise the boy for being ignorant enough to have gotten himself into this situation, which had effectively robbed an innocent fox bear of its life. Gon took these words to heart and vowed to raise the cub as penance, prompting Kite to ask who the boy's father was, only to discover that Gon was the son of his master, Jing Freaks. Now, unfortunately, very little is known about Kite's past, although the 2011 anime did expand on it somewhat. But in the end, the primary factor of importance was meeting Jing, who saw potential in Kite and took him on as his student, teaching him how to hunt as well as the principles of Nen. Furthermore, Kite was also privy to many of Jing's exploits and was even taken into the game of Greed Island. Kite would then go on to take the hunter exam and manage to pass it with ease. However, his final test would come from Jing himself, who gave Kite the seemingly simple task of finding him. And yes, while that does sound like a rather glorified game of hide and seek, Kite claims that this task was the most difficult hunt in the world. And in order to achieve it, Kite had come to Whale Island in order to seek out any information from Jing's family. Now, at this stage, Gon really knew nothing about his father, and it was Kite who inspired him to become a hunter and one day find Jing himself, embarking on the exact same quest that Kite was already on. This was sparked because Kite possesses the utmost respect and admiration for Jing, and the more Kite told Gon, the more Gon developed his own personal sense of admiration for his mysterious father. As a parting gift and or challenge, Kite even provided Gon with Jing's hunter's license before departing the island to complete his task. And eventually, he did find Jing. Although notably, this was only shown in the 2011 anime. But after this initial appearance in the very first chapter, the character of Kite would be set to simmer, not appearing again until chapter 185, when Gon and Killua were sent to him via the power of an accompanying card following their victory on Greed Island. At this stage, Kite had been hired by the Kakin Kingdom to conduct ecological research with his own personal team of aspiring hunters, leading to the alarming discovery of the Chimera Ants. Kite, accompanied by Gon and Killua, then embarked into the Neo-Green Life Autonomous State in order to suppress and exterminate the Chimera Ant Queen. However, these creatures who originated on the Dark Continent were subject to rapid evolution. So while Kite was initially using Chimera Ants to test Gon and Killua's capabilities, things would shortly take a very serious turn, and it would be here that Kite's true power would be displayed for the first time. In regards to Nen, Kite is a conjurer, and his primary use of Nen appears in the form of various weapons with a smack-talking clown affixed to them, known as Crazy Slots. To activate this ability, Kite conjures his clown friend, which commences a slot machine containing the numbers 1 through 9, with each of these numbers corresponding to a different weapon that the Crazy Slots ability has the potential to turn into. The unfortunate kicker is that due to this random nature, Kite is unable to choose what weapon to use in any given scenario. However, this was a condition specifically attached to the ability in order to increase the potency of the weapons conjured. In the series thus far, we have only seen three of these numbers activated, one of which results in a scythe, another a carbine, and the third is a very mysterious mace, the function of which was never shown. In regards to this though, Kite's master Jing has mentioned that there is a number that will only pop up when Kite desperately does not want to die, implying that this mace may have saved him from being removed from this world. Speaking of, things escalated very, very quickly during the Chimera Ant arc, resulting in Nefapito being born, a creature of absurd power who managed to eclipse even Kite in every aspect of combat. This was the situation in which Kite drew slot number 3, the mysterious mace, but whatever power it held, it did not save him, as Nefapito proceeded to kill and dismember him. Now, for most characters in fiction, a death by beheading would be where this video tragically ends, but we do have a couple of things left to go through here. Following his death, Kite's corpse would go on to play a major role in the story, as it had been adopted by Nefapito and given a form of life through the Dr. Blythe Nen ability. Nefapito did this because they enjoyed their fight so much that Nefapito desperately wished for it to happen again, so why not? Let's raise the dead. Sort of. And after being discovered by Gon, Kite's corpse and the subsequent revelation that Nefapito would be unable to completely revive him sent Gon into a fit of Nen-fueled rage and despair, culminating in the brutal demise of Nefapito. And yet, we still don't conclude the story there, because Kite would actually end up being reborn into this world through the Chimera Ant Queen herself. In fact, Kite actually popped out at the same time as Meruem, the Ant King, making them biological twins. This teeny tiny baby Kite was then taken by Colt, who would end up betraying the Ant Legion, and so Kite was raised as a human under the protection of the Hunter Association. And here we also may need to change our pronouns a bit, because Kite was reborn into this world as a biological female. Furthermore, due to the whole being a Chimera Ant thing, Kite grew rapidly. By the time the arc was over, Kite had the appearance of a young teenager. To add to this, unlike many humans who were directly converted into ants, Kite appears to retain the memory of her former self and was delighted when Gon came to visit her. Currently, it is assumed that Kite still resides within the protection of the Hunter Association, along with her previous group of aspiring hunters. Small fun facts about Kite. Having been trained by Jing Freaks, Kite is one of the more phenomenal users of Nen in the world, with one example being his profound use of N, which can cover a radius of up to 45 meters and is completely undetectable to the large majority of other Nen users, such as Gon and Killua. In the 2011 anime, Kite's story has changed somewhat, and he does not appear until the commencement of the Chimera Ant arc, after which point Gon suddenly remembers that he had met Kite in the past, and the events of the first chapter play out in a flashback. This is a move that put many Hunter x Hunter fans offside, as it removed Gon's major motivation to become a hunter in the first place, and the fact that he kind of just conveniently forgot about Kite until meeting him again is admittedly just a little bit hard to swallow. There is a running gag in relation to Kite's use of the Crazy Slots ability, whereby a number will pop up and Kite will deem it to be a bad number, only for the weapon in question to end up being the perfect solution for his situation at the time. And finally, a truly useless fact. In the 1999 anime, Kite was made noticeably more handsome than in the manga or the 2011 version. Also, he had brown hair, and to someone who began watching the 2011 series and then moved to the manga, I find that very, very weird. But that pretty much does it for Kite. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produced in general, then please do consider donating to the New World Review Patreon, because the support of all of your amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. And if Patreon isn't quite your style, then please do leave this video a like, share, or subscribe, because it also helps support this channel an incredible amount. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with who, what, or where you'd like to see featured on the next Hunter x Hunter 101.